All right, this is what a side yard should look like. We got done with the planting the gooseberries and the blueberries. And they came in the mail 2 days ago and have been in a box. So the blueberries actually still look pretty good for coming from all the way on the west coast. And what I did was did a little bit of sheet mulching. So under here, there's cardboard. I know some people don't like to use cardboard, but it's a quick way to kill the grass. And basically what we're trying to do here is we put a light layer of mulch, because if you look over here, let me find it real quick here. Yeah, somewhere around here. But anyway, there's a lot of clover. We planted some beans. There's some coming up there. But anyway, we planted quite a few different things in between these black raspberries. And over here, we planted some feverfew, chamomile, some African giant marigold. And basically, I found out over here that this soil I put on top of cardboard dries out quickly. And one thing that I'd recommend doing is soaking the cardboard like in a wheelbarrow full of water first. And then putting your soil on top, laying it down, putting your soil on top. Well, actually I soaked that on this side. Over here, I just waited till I watered everything, and that was a mistake. It didn't absorb enough. So over here, we soaked the cardboard, and we soaked the dirt, the soil, and then when putting the mulch on, I actually soaked that in water also. It's been helping retain a little bit more water, because just spraying off the mulch with water, it dehydrated pretty quickly. So I would have used straw, but I didn't have that available, and I had about the second worst mulch I could have used. This is cypress. I put a light layer on, and I'm hoping all the clover and the everything else I planted, the legumes, we planted dragon bean, yellow wax bean, peas. Just, I don't eat a lot of that stuff, but it's, I might as well have it being used for something. So that was the whole point of that. That way we can transfer to a living mulch. But yeah, I've never grown gooseberries before, and they look pretty good for being April. The bumblebees are all over. I strongly recommend flower gardens. All go well with gardens, just due to the pollinators that you'll get from it. And here's the update with the garden. Not much growing. Again, the soil's basically dry on top, but we're trying not to water and let our cover crop start to retain the moisture. I did plant some strawberries. They are coming up in various areas. This is what I call Strawberry Alley down here. We're gonna have strawberries all the way up here, and there's when it's flowering now. I'd like to pinch those flowers off for the first year and let them become more established. It's growing strawberries before the leaves are even out. So anyway, that was my little update. I'm just not feeling too well today. Feeling sick, so I was trying to get something done outside, because I always feel better when I'm outside. Even the grapes are starting to come in here. Oh yeah, the bamboo update. I see the neighbor found a a lot of the ones that are growing in their yard because they just chopped them off and threw them in my yard. But that's fine. They don't even live there. They're just taking care of the property for somebody else. So I think we have a little bumblebee nest over here in the old fire pit. That's why I've been seeing so many this year. But we'll leave it alone. Haven't had a fire in a while. Well, that's about it. Well, have a good day.